Views is Drake's fourth studio album, released back in 2016. With an impressive lineup of features, credits, and four genres across 20 songs, Views stands as Drake's best mainstream effort, yet most slept on project. Back in 2014, after the release of the hugely successful album Nothing Was The Same, an album known as Views From The Six was announced. A full 2 years before its eventual release in 2016, under the shortened title, Views. Many artists will agree that prematurely announcing a project will often do more harm than good, resulting in fans being inevitably disappointed when they finally get to hear the music. A good example of this is with Kanye's latest album, Donda. In 2015, Drake would go on to release two hugely successful mixtapes, with hype continuing to build for this Views album. If you're reading this, it's too late, and What A Time To Be Alive, both filled with Drake's best trap music, with production from the genre's greatest in Metro Boomin, Southside, Frank Dukes, and Boy Wonder. These mixtapes were designed to dominate the club scene, with catchy beats and memorable punchlines, but with Views, Drake had other ideas. Views was to be the ultimate expression of Drake's influences and a demonstration of the diverse artistry he possesses. It definitely achieves this, as we hear Drake effortlessly singing on a dancehall beat and then delivering some of his best pen game. Another side of Views is the way it conveys the changing seasons of Toronto, which often inspires Drake's music, with the aesthetic of cold winters in the sense of weather and also atmosphere being shown on tracks such as Keep the Family Close or You With Me, shortly after transitioning to a bright and tropical vibe with tracks like One Dance or Controller. Toronto, just like the UK, is a hub for African culture and music, and this side of the city is shown very clearly on this album, providing the songs to bring these genres to the top of the mainstream charts, and Drake along with it. The album features some of Drake's best vocal performances to date, with tracks such as Feel No Ways or Redemption, really demonstrating the artist's progression as a singer.
A lot of people don't like this project.
This album just goes on and on and on and on.
Drake took a step back when it came to rapping. Basically, it's just not good.
It's a filler album.
Views was to be Drake's masterpiece, with the aim to make another cohesive listening experience just like he had done before. Did Views get the same recognition with the fans as Nothing Was The Same, Take Care, or If You're Reading This It's Too Late? I feel Views was definitely ahead of its time and was to be the album that signified Drake's transition to a more mainstream sound. Perhaps you didn't like Views the first time you heard it when it was released, but if you go and listen to Views today, you'll most likely agree with me and say it's grown on you, with Drake himself predicting this would happen when he said this on the track Wants and Needs. The album Views has some of Drake's biggest songs, responsible for his mainstream success, such as Hotline Bling or One Dance, and the list can go on, making Views Drake's most successful album, selling just shy of an unbelievable 10 million copies since its release in 2016. Acting as the soundtrack to a city filled with highs, lows, and all kinds of different sounds and experiences. Views has three main ingredients that make up the final product and show off the diverse culture that runs through the city. Firstly, we have the slow and moody sound that Drake has been known for that makes his way onto almost every one of his projects. Created by the one and only Noah 40 Shabib, with the use of ambient textures, underwater melodies, stripped down drum grooves, and vocal riffs. We can't give 40 all the credit, as there are plenty more big names all over these tracks, such as Kanye West, Vinyls, and OZ. The second is the commercial pop and dancehall sound that is present on this album. This new sound was brought to us by producer Paul Jeffries, also known as 1985. The Toronto native brought into the OVO camp after producing Hold On We're Going Home by 40 himself. You may have never heard of 1985 before, but you've definitely heard his music. One Dance, With You, and Hotline Bling, these catchy tracks being the main reason Views stands as Drake's biggest album. What makes these songs so great aside from Drake's input is the infectious bounce of the beats, through catchy chord progressions, rhythmic percussion loops, and deep bass grooves. All things we need to replicate when creating our beat for this category. Finally, we have the trap sound that made its way from the two hit mixtapes, If You're Reading This It's Too Late, and What A Time To Be Alive, and leaked into the track list of Views. The tracks Hype, Grammys, and Pop Style are created by the same producers behind these iconic mixtapes. With bouncy drum patterns, dark melodies, and hard 808s, Views definitely doesn't lack in this department. Thanks to our sponsor, Sourceware, we have one of the best new plugins that's going to help us replicate the trap sound from Views. Their latest sound generator plugin, Scorch, is built specifically for rap producers who want to make these type of beats. With a simple UI and hundreds of presets, this plugin is easy to use and can help you create unique and high-quality melodies. Check out this crazy mod wheel that, when turned, will transform any preset into a completely different sound. allowing you to sound design your own presets all under one roof. With a built-in chord generator and many categories of presets, this plugin is a must-have for making rap instrumentals. If you want to get this plugin right now, just click the link below and use the code JACK at checkout to get a nice discount. Overall, Views serves as another testament to Drake's artistry and definitely deserves more respect. In this episode of The Blueprint, we're going to cover all aspects of this album. We have three beats to make with a clear vision in mind, so let's get started. So for this Blueprint, we're going to be starting off with a dancehall beat, and I'm going to be using a kalimba as my main chord sound. And to give our chord sound a little bit more body, I'm going to be layering it with a noir felt piano from Kontakt. For the chords, I wanted to keep them pretty simple, nothing too crazy, just enough to get a vibe going. To give our melody that underwater kind of sound, I'm going to be decreasing the sample rate through Edison, just like you see us do in the first Drake Blueprint video. And right here, we're just adding some reverb to give it a bit more ambience, and then taking off a bit of low end with an EQ. Next, we're going to get a drum bounce going, and I'm going to be using my dancehall drum kit, which is in the drum collection. If you're trying to make some dancehall beats, this is definitely the kit for you. So check it out, link down in the description. And this is a fairly generic kind of dancehall drum bounce that we've got here, just to get us started. So while I was making the drums, I realized that our melody wasn't really bouncing right, it was a bit off, so I've just chopped it up here to make it fit nicer. To give it that kind of real dancehall flavor, we need to add in these really nice real drum perks. This is gonna make our drum pattern sound super authentic. So here's a little tip for you guys. When you're adding loads of drum sounds, it's pretty easy to get kind of carried away. So what I like to do is I like to just get everything into its own pattern and then just start with the basics, kick, snare, and then just bring everything in slowly until it sounds like it's too much. It just makes it a little bit easier to identify. So time to add our synth bass, and I'm just going to be following the ghost notes from the chords to get the right notes in there. And I found some cool sound effects from this Big White Beats drum kit, so I'm going to put those in there as well. They sound super good. I decided it would be best to create an alternate bass pattern, one that's a little bit more busy for maybe like a chorus section. So here's what that sounds like. So to give our bass some more bounce, I'm going to be adding a one beat gate from Grossbeat, which is just going to cut the bass sound in and out. And to complete the beat, the last thing I'm going to be adding is a vocal chop from Hooked in Arcade. And then we're going to just decrease the sample rate to really filter it out and put it in the background. So I wasn't really feeling the synth bass sound, so I've just switched it out for one in my dancehall drum kit, and it sounds so much better. So here's our breakdown section between our chorus and verses. It's just a more slowed down section with some slightly different drums, really, you know, stripped down. So with our new shaker sound, I've just decided to pitch down a few of the notes so they're a little bit lower, and it just creates a really nice bounce. And one final last touch, we've just decided to pitch down our main melody an octave just to make it sound even more slow and kind of moody. And that is our first beat completed. So let's check it out right here. And just so you guys can really hear where I'm going with this beat, I've decided to put the controller a cappella over it. And yeah, it sounds pretty sweet. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments. But yeah, that's the dancehall beat.
My AI just changed. It just paused the front gate. I thank God you came. How many more days could I wait? I made plans with you that I won't let them fall through. I think I lie for you. I think I die for you. Jealousy cry for you. Do things when you want me to. Like controller, controller. Yeah, like controller, controller. Okay, you like it when I get aggressive. Tell you to go slower, go faster. Like controller, controller. Yeah, like controller, controller. And I'm never on a wasting shawty. I do it how you say you want it. Them girls, they just wanna take my money. They don't want me to give you nothing. They don't want you to have nothing. They don't wanna see me find your love. They don't wanna see me smiling back when they pre-knowing I lie for you. Thinking I die for you. Jealousy cry for you. Do things when you want me. Like controller, controller, yeah. Like controller, controller.
So that is the dancehall beat done, and I hope you guys enjoyed that one. That one was really fun to make. With this one, I really wanted to make sure that it sounds like a mainstream kind of commercial dancehall beat. And as you can hear with the controller acapella on it, it sounds sick. I'm really happy with this one, how it turned out. It's simple, but it ticks all the right boxes, you know. It does its job. It's a great beat for Drake. There's that beat done. That's the commercial dancehall side of views covered. Let's move on to the next one. So on to the second beat, and in this one we're going to be making the trap beat. Kicking things off, we're going to be using the Scorch plugin paired up with the Blueprint MIDI kit. This MIDI kit has over 1,000 MIDIs for trap, drill, R&B, and we're just using a chord progression here from that pack to create our melody. So this right here demonstrates my two favorite things about this Scorch plugin: all the crazy presets that are just super easy to find, and this crazy mod wheel as well. So to get a slightly different vibe out of this chord progression, I've just pitched it up a few notes to E minor. This is really reminding me of that song off of Views, Still Here. So I think that's the direction we're going to go in with this beat. So with the drum pattern, I'm going to be trying to mold it after a typical Boy Wonder drum pattern. So we're going to be using some really typical trap sounds here, starting off with the snare. And I've just put this little roll in here just to spice things up a little bit. The main goal with these drums is to make them really bouncy and create a nice rhythm for Drake's vocals to sit on. So with the 808 again, we're just following the root notes of the chords to make sure we got all the right notes. And yeah, this 808 is quite simple, nothing too crazy, just enough to make the beat that much harder. RC20 is one of my favorite effects to add to melodies, just to give it a bit of a vintage effect, you know, with some noise, a bit of detuning and some distortion. It really makes all the difference. So to make the melody even more bouncy, we've chucked it into Fruity Slicer to give us that nice two-step bounce, just like the drums. for our verse section, once again, we're going to be taking our melody and pitching it down an octave just to switch things up a little bit, keep the beat a little bit more interesting rather than being too repetitive. So to make our 808 pattern a little bit more interesting, I'm going to be just adding a slide note here. So when it goes up to the G5, it's going to slide back down to a G4. I found this cool little sound in one of my drum kits. I'm just putting that in and it's creating this nice little bounce. It's just a more creative option than using, say, an open hat, for example. Right here, I'm working on a little effect to put on the beat before it drops, just to make the drop hit a little bit harder. I felt like this beat was really missing a counter melody, so we've loaded up Scorch again and we found this sound, so we're gonna craft that now. This counter melody is really simple and just complements the chords really nicely. And we're actually using the same notes, just like the 808 as the chords, so it just keeps everything very concise. If you want to make your kick cut through the mix a little bit more, then what you have to do is you have to sidechain it to your 808. The way we're doing that is with the fruity limiter right here, just linking them together and creating that sidechain. I just want to say a massive thank you to Jacob and the guys at Sourceware Audio for sponsoring this video and giving me the opportunity to showcase Scorch to you guys. If you like what you see here, then click the link down in the description, check it out. So the second beat is now done and I've chucked on another Drake acapella. There's going to be Drake acapellas on all these beats you're hearing today, and this is the one from Still Here, the song that inspired this beat. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. Check it out. I'm in the city still, I'm still here, dog. How did I finesse all of this shit from Jane and Weston? Girls all in my bed and they don't trip off first impression. Girls all in your bed and they just ask a honest question. I can't fuck with you no more cause you be acting extra. Do your favorite rapper like my son, no. Nothing mutual about my funds, though. All you niggas fighting over crumbs, where the bread at? How they feel about you? Where you from, where your bed at? I don't need no pill to speak my mind, I don't need that. I make people pay me for my time, yeah, I need that. And I see your girl like all the time, no. I can't tell you if she's yours or mine, but I do know. Me and all my niggas doing well, dawg. You not from the city, I could tell, dawg. Did it by myself, dawg. Blew up and I'm in the city still, I'm still here, dawg. Oh. So that is the trap element of Views covered with that beat there. With this beat, I really wanted to make sure that I included the Boy Wonder style drums, which we did there. Bouncy, pretty minimalistic with a few little, a few little twists in there to spice things up. And also like a Frank Dukes-ish, you know, Q-beat style melody as well with some of our processing and, you know, obviously the sound design from Scorch. And Scorch was a massive help with this one. And we put the Still Here acapella on it. Shut down. Sounds fire. So that's the trap one done. Let's move on to the third and final beat. So time to start the third beat. This one's going to be a classic kind of like slow Drake rapping beat that is on almost every single Drake album. And we're starting off with some big kind of emotional R&B chords from my Blueprint MIDI kit. We're going to export them, run them through Edison, decrease the sample rate, giving us that underwater sound that we like. So to go with our chords, we're adding a synth bass here, just following the root note of each chord. As always, I love to start doing the drums as early as I can to get the bounce in there. For this beat, we're going to be using the Analog Colors drum kit, which I've brought back for you guys. So if you want to get that as well, I'll also be leaving a link to that down in the description. If you want to get those vintage kind of hip-hop drum sounds, this is perfect for you. So we've chopped up our sample and we're now changing up the bass as well, just to make things a little bit shorter, a bit more bouncy, that'll work nicer with drums. So to spice things up a little bit, we're adding some perks from this drum kit, some open hats, a few little sounds that are just going to accent our drums nicely. So the groundwork for our beat is now done. This is all the basic elements put together. Now it's time to take things to the next level. Right now we're inside Analog Lab looking for a nice little counter melody sound, and I came across this one right here. It sounds dope. With some reverb added, here's what it sounds like with the rest of our beat playing. So I wasn't really feeling the melody on the actual drop with the drums. So what I've done is I've just chopped the first note and I'm just looping it, and it sounds so good. It makes it sound like it's been sampled or something. And here's the vocal chop to really tie this sample together. We're going to be using distant voices inside an arcade. Tell how those counter melodies accents have just really transformed this beat and made it much more interesting and unique. So the third and final beat of this video is now done. Yeah, sounds dope, and here's yet again another Drake acapella for you to enjoy. Let me know what you think down in the comments. What's your favorite beat? Check it out.
On some DMX shit, I group DM my exes. I tell them they belong to me, that goes on for forever. And I think we just get closer when we not together. You tell me that I'm confusing, more immature than Marcus Houston. Cuts too deep for a band-aid solution. We too deep in this thing and never lose me. LOL, LOL, I'm glad you finding shit amusing. Heard a lot about me before we started off. I know you heard of my pool parties like Mardi Gras. I know you heard of my girl is sponsored by Audemars. That's why she always correcting me when my time is up. And my house is the definition of alcohol and weed addiction. You got a different vision. You wanna walk around naked in the kitchen without running into one of my niggas. It's not the way we living. Too much going on, it's just not realistic. These days I don't talk about them days like I miss them. And you shouldn't miss them either, we different people. But every time we speak it, it's like a lot of games being played. How's it going down? So until we gone, and I got to know now. Is you with me or what?
Bird and Final Beat Done. That one is my absolute favorite. I can't even lie. Undeniably sick. I love the vocal chops in there. It just sounds like such a Drake beat, you know what I'm saying? And we obviously, once again, acapella's on there from You With Me, which is probably my favorite song off of you. It's one of my favorites, you know, top three for sure. You know, and this is one of those classic freestyle kind of beats for Drake that he's been known to use. I hope you guys did enjoy. Let me know down in the comments which beat was your favorite. And yeah, that's basically the video done. I really hope you guys did enjoy. Once again, this video took a hell of a lot of time, so I would really appreciate it if you guys would just take a second to just click the subscribe button below if you're not already, and also leave a like on this video. Also, before we go, I just want to say a massive thank you for 50,000 subscribers. We've just hit that milestone. I'm super, super grateful. I'm going to do a video on its own to kind of talk about that a little bit more in the future, but I just want to say thank you to you guys. Follow me on the gram at ProbByJack. I'll see you in the next one. Have a great day. Toying with it like Happy Meal. Three dots, you thinking of a reaction still. While you typing, make sure you tell me what type of games are being played. How's it going down? So until we gone, and I got to know now.